Students begin to graduate college, they may be looking to get their own place, and the problem is most students are still dealing with their school debt. So joining us with more information on some tips to really balance it all out is mortgage expert Brian Sachs. Brian, thanks for coming.
Thank you for having me.
All right, so what do students first need to keep in mind as they graduate?
Well, there's really a number of issues. So there's about $1.5 trillion worth of school loans out there, and there are 44 million Americans that have school loans. And it does impact you when you come for a mortgage. You know, whether your loan is in deferment or forbearance or you're still in school, most lenders are going to look at your school loan debt and they're going to count 1% of it as a debt against you. So if you have $47,000, which is very common in school loans, a lender is going to count $470 a month as a debt against you. And that's a pretty significant debt. Unfortunately, it disqualifies many people from obtaining a mortgage.
Well, so what are students supposed to do?
Well, there's a couple things. So there's really two categories. There are folks who should consolidate loans. There are forgiveness programs that many people aren't aware of. You know, when you have school loans, they're usually stacked and they're different interest rates. So look into consolidating your school loans is one way to do it. There are other folks, unfortunately, it's estimated 1 million Americans have school loans in default. And this is really a problem.
Well, you can't just ignore it.
You can't ignore it. And here's why they don't let you ignore it. Because if you get a refund, the IRS will take your refund. If you are also in default, you could have a wage garnishment. And that wage garnishment could be up to 25% of your wages.
Whoa.
But there's good news always, okay?
And you're giving us the balance.
Right. The good news is that you can get your loans out of default. There are rehab programs, and some of them as little as $5 a month, which almost anyone could do.
Well, yeah, sure, anyone can do that. But then the idea is you eventually want to be in a position where you can buy a home, and interest rates are so much lower now.
They're so low. And you know, we really did not expect this. It's a perfect time for folks to think about refinancing. We have a great situation because homes have been appreciating very nicely as well. So there may be an opportunity to get rid of mortgage insurance. There may be an opportunity to pull equity out. And here's something really neat. I have a lot of clients right now that are going from a 30-year mortgage to a 15-year mortgage, cutting their term in half and still saving money every month, which is really, really awesome financially.
So you mentioned the loan forgiveness. How can students find out more about that?
Well, there are companies like Education Loan Consultants. There are a number of companies out there that actually can facilitate it. It becomes sometimes a little bit of a cumbersome process. Every consumer can do this on their own. Okay, they can log into the federal system and try to consolidate, but there are companies out there that will help them do this as well and help them with rehabs.
Well, and attention spans really aren't what they used to be. So we really need more guidance, I think, now more than ever. Not just for young people, but for older people,
Too. You need to know the ins and outs of all the programs and know what your options are. And sometimes it's best to have a company facilitate that for you.
All right, and the benefits of consolidating your loans?
Well, number one, you're going to have a lower interest rate. Number two, you're going to clean up your credit report because instead of 15 school loans, you're going to have them all consolidated into one. And again, you may have a lower monthly payment than you would just keeping things as they are.
That's a big benefit right there. Brian, thanks
so
much for coming in. Appreciate it.
Thank you.